function is doing. Now let's throw more light on what we mean by return type of a function. See here, we have a small piece of code, and in this piece of code, the return type over here is void. When you have void over here as the return type, you need not return anything. Even if you eliminate or not use this return, your code will run exactly fine. So when you have void, you need not put this return statement. Even if you put it, it's not a problem. Now come here. This is a void return type. This is an int return type. If you may see, when you have int return type, you have to return by default an integer answer. So you may see over here that this is a variable declaration. Sum is computing the sum of num1 and num2, and these are in the argument list. And then I compute sum and then return sum. Mind you, there has to be a semicolon over here, which is not there. And then close the braces. So the return type will be an integer and not a float over here. In this case, we have a float return type. It's returning distance. Now distance has to be declared as float. So we have over here a local variable declaration. And then you have to terminate your function definition with a curly brace. Keep that in mind, please. So we have seen what we mean by void as a return type, int as a return type, float as a return type. You may consider doing this also for char as a return type. Moving on ahead, let's see writing a function with void return type. So the basic function structure is over here. So return type void. Function name over here is introduction. Argument list is empty. Block of code is all this. Printf hi, printf my name is Chaitanya, printf how are you. In this function, we do not have any local variable declaration. This is a void return type, so it need not return anything. Even if you had to say return semicolon, it wouldn't be wrong. And then I have closed the curly brace. Now let's go ahead to see what is a int return type. Int is your return type here. Name of the function is addition. Argument list is two of them, int num1 and num2. Block of code is all this. Sum equal to num1 plus num2. However, we have a local variable declaration, that is int sum. And then you're returning back something, that is your sum. You'll have to put a semicolon over here. And then you terminate the function body. So this first line over here is your function header. From here to here, whatever is enclosed within the curly braces is your function body. Okay. So when we talk about functions, we can broadly classify them as a function with arguments and without return value, a function with arguments and with return value, a function without arguments, without return value, and a function without arguments and with a return value. Okay, so you may read this as with return value and you may read this as with return value. Alright, so no return value means it's void type. No, without return value means void type. So here I will have to specify void. My name of the function in this case is x. I'm accepting an argument. This is a. Now arguments in the argument list of a function definition are called as passive parameters or formal parameters. I repeat, arguments in the argument list of a function definition are called as formal parameters. So a is a formal parameter of the type integer. So since this is void, I am not using return, but I will have to tell the user that something is happening when I call this function. So then I say printf, printing percentage d format specifier, and in that a goes and sits. So whatever comes in over here from the main program goes and sits in here and then is displayed out here. Similarly, here I have a return type, okay, and I have arguments. So this was without return value, now this is with return value. Because it has some return type, there has to be something specified over here. So for now I say int. Now default return type is int. For example, if I had not written void here, just left it as x and then carried on, then you would have to interpret the default return type as int. So int x, int a, similar to what I had mentioned here. But in this case, since you have a return type, you will have to say return something. So what are you returning over here? You're returning a. There's nothing else that you have in your code to return. So by default, you'll be returning a in this case. Now this explains without arguments, without return value. So there are no arguments here. So this is empty and no return value. So void. So how will you tell the user that the function is doing something? You use a display message. Printf hello. Now without arguments, that means this will be empty, but you're returning something. You may return float, you may return char, you may return int. So I am demonstrating with the help of int. So int, name of the function, nothing in here. But you have to return something. So I have my local variable declarations. Now mind you, here a came from the main. Here also a came from the main. You had a value of a here. But since this doesn't have any arguments, you will have to locally declare it. So a is equal to 50. You could have just said return a, or in this case, this is using b, this is using sum. Sum is equal to a plus b, and then I'm returning sum. So you have to understand that without arguments means this bracket is empty. With arguments means there is something in this bracket. Without return value means you will be making use of void here. With return value means you will either make use of int, char, float, double, and whenever you make use of a return type, make sure you are returning something. Now see, for example, over here we have a code which is a function, and this is a void return type. So you cannot have return something, but however you will have to tell the main program that you have performed the addition of two numbers. So this is a program for with arguments and without return value. So how are you going to tell the user that you have computed the sum of whatever has come in these formal parameters? That is with the use of display messages. So the display messages over here are displayed in the form of using printfs. The local variable declaration is int sum, and you have done whatever you want your function to do by making use of sum is equal to var1 plus var2. Next we have a code. Now this is a code with no arguments, and it has a return value at line number 13. Now because it has a return value or a return type at line number 13, I will have to return something, and that something that I am returning has to be of data type int. So all this at line number 15 are local variable declarations. Line number 16 is your code that you want your function to do, and line number 17 is your returning back. Now let's see how this functions. Okay.